exciting. And this is what I want to start off to tell you. I did this exercise about 3 years ago with my husband and I, and it was transformational in our parenting. Now, I don't mean to be so dramatic, but I want you to know it was very powerful. So you got the email, and you know today we're talking about values. Now, here's the deal. Dave, my husband, went and he sat down by himself and he wrote down 6 values that were really important to him in raising our children, and I did the same. And then we came together, and some were the same and some were not. And so we took those similar values and really discussed the importance, and we decided on just 3. Now, you're probably thinking, Maria, I want my kid to have all the things. I want them to have character as far as, like, you know, perseverance and courage and bravery and love and kindness. I want all the things. But let's pick 3, and I'm going to tell you why. Because those 3 things are going to give you focus. They're going to give you focus when the going gets tough and you're ready to yell and scream at your kids, and you take a deep breath and you remember Dismondis are kind. So we have 3 values that Dave and I have decided on. And when we are going throughout the day in our parenting style, and we're working with our kids, and we're you know, living with our kids, we try to exude these 3 character traits. We've talked to the kids about it, and we actually put it on a refrigerator. We use these words a lot. The kids all know what our family value statement is, and we also made a little mantra that was a little bit simpler for them to remember. So you want this to be simple, concise, and memorable. Friends, we are not making a family mission statement that looks like a company, like, you know, a company would have on their wall. This is a family statement, a family value statement. So here's ours. Be a Dismondi is the mantra, and it's, in our family, we are kind, we work hard, and we have fun. So let me show you how this plays in our parenting, okay? So the siblings are arguing, and they're being mean to each other. I stop them and I go back to our values and I say, all right, listen, I want you to hear the words you're using with your brother. Are you being kind?
No.
Well, Dismondis are kind. So we need to reframe what you're saying to your brother, because Dismondis are kind. Another example on grades. So my 4th grader comes home, is super excited because she got a good score on her math test, and we value work ethic in our home. And so instead of just saying, I'm so proud of you, got 100%, that's amazing, this is what we say. You have been doing your math homework every single day after school. You've been working hard for this test to show that. You've been working so hard every day. So we really try to pride our children on their effort, not the results, okay? So their effort in doing something, not just the end product. I was not a very good student, and I felt like I was only happy when I got good grades because that showed that I was worthy. Not true, because I work really hard. I may not get the best grades, but I work really hard. And it's the same in my life right now. Like, I'm not a test taker. You know, when I became a teacher, I remember being so nervous to take the teaching test. And I passed, but it wasn't with, like, amazing flying colors. Was I a good teacher? Yes, I was, because I was, like, 110%, and I loved what I did. So number 3 is to have fun. And you're probably thinking, like, why is have fun one of your values? And I'm going to tell you why. My husband, Dave, and I, we both are entrepreneurs, and we both work hard. And we have to remind each other to chill out and to have fun. So we put that part of our value statement because our children want to be with us right now. Our children love being with us. They're at the age that they want us to play games. They want us to read them books. They want to have dance parties. So have fun is to remind Dave and I to enjoy these moments with our children. So that part of the mission statement was really just to remind Dave and I to have fun with our kids, to be present, and to just really enjoy the ride. So today, you're going to go into your homework because you are committed. Look at all these people committed. We've got Sarah, my friend Sandra. We've got Nika, Judy, Rachel, Katie, my friend in California. We have over the total number, Lisa is on there. The total number of people was over 800 people joining this challenge. 800 people committed to being a better parent, okay? So being the parent they want to be. So today, I want you to go. I want you to get off this call. Take a few moments for your workbook. And if you have a spouse or a partner, allow them a little bit of space and time tonight to figure out three values that they value. Do the work, guys. Do the work. If you want to get fancy, you can put a mission statement on your fridge like this. Tell your kids what it is. Tell your kids what it means. This is going to transform your parenting. It's going to help you to feel laser focused. So tomorrow we are talking about something real exciting. You're going to get that email at 6 a.m. We are talking about self-care tomorrow. It's going to be amazing. It's going to be great. I want you to show up here. I want you to read your email, do your workbook, and tag me on Instagram, Maria Desmondi Books. This has been so much fun, and I thank you for all your positive feedback. I honestly just want us to team together and to remind each other that this journey of parenting is hard. It looks messy. It doesn't always look perfect. We've got to give ourselves grace, but it's the best journey of all. Thanks, everyone. Have a great day.